So tonight, for your homework, this is basically your density review sheet. So I'm going to go through a couple of the problems on the density review sheet. I talked to you guys today, so some people said they might need help with number 7, number 9, and number 4. Okay, so like I told you guys, we always start with D equals M over V. Okay, now for this particular problem, okay, this tells me that I need to find which one does this go with. So because this is a ratio, okay, this is grams per centimeter squared, that tells me it's probably a density. Okay, so I'm going to say density. Okay, and then over here, 0.10 grams is a mass. Okay, so in this case, I know my D, I know my M, but what I don't know is my volume. Okay, so really what I have is 3.5 grams per centimeter cubed is equal to 0.10 grams divided by volume, whatever volume might be. Now, there's a couple different ways we can do this. Okay, the first way, which I think is the easiest way, okay, is this way. Okay, so basically I use this chart. Okay, so basically it's a triangle with M at the top and then D and V at the bottom. Okay, so the idea is that whatever you don't know, you cover up. So in this case, if I don't know density, it's equal to mass divided by volume. That's how I got the original equation off to the side here. Now, in this case, I know density, and I know mass, but I don't know volume. So then I can cover up volume. So I know my answer is going to be mass divided by density. Okay, so now I can come over here, right, and I can say that volume is equal to mass over density. Okay, and the way I got that was that this center line here is a division line. Okay, so that division line is telling me that this is divided by that. Okay, so now I know that mass divided by density, and I know my mass, which is 0.10 gram divided by 3.5 grams per centimeter cubed. Okay, so now I just do my math. Okay, and so now, Okay, so make sure you turn your calculator on, which is nice. So 0.10 divided by 3.5. Okay, so now in this case, okay, so I know that my gram divided by gram is 1. So my units are going to now be in centimeters cubed. So what I have is 0.03 grams per centimeter. Sorry, I knew that. See, that's how sometimes you make a mistake. 0.03 centimeters cubed would be your answer. That's your volume. Okay, because remember, you crossed off your grams, and so now all you have is cubic centimeters. Okay, so in this case, it's 0.03 cubic centimeters. Okay, now in this problem number 9, that's what we're doing next. Okay, so this one is a little bit different. Okay, this is also, so if we start with D equals M over V. Okay, so in this case, we're going to have to deal with a few different things. So now this one, so initially, the water level was 40 milliliters. So we're talking about volume, so there's 40 milliliters, 40.0 milliliters. Okay, so then, now the difference between 40 and, so it's going to say, it started at 40, but then it ended at 63.4 milliliters. Okay, so we can say that the difference, okay, so we take this one here. So we say 63.4 minus 40. Okay, the difference of those two. Okay, so now, right? So 0 from 4 is 4. 0 from 3 is 3. 4 from 6 is 2. Okay, so we can say it's 23.4 milliliters is the volume of that copper. Okay, this guy right here, because we took this one minus that one. Okay, so the difference. Okay, so this, you would say this is the V initial, okay, the initial height, but then the V final Okay, so the difference between those, so V final minus V initial. Okay, so in this case, so now we know the density. So now we know volume is equal to 23.4 milliliters. Okay, and so now we also know the density. This guy here is density. Okay, so what we want to find is the mass. Okay, so now we know D is equal to 8.9 grams per centimeter cubed. Okay, so now what we want to find out what mass is equal to. Okay, so we take the same chart here that I used originally. Okay, so now mass is equal to density times volume. Okay, so I'll start with that equation. Right, so mass is equal to density times volume. So now I know my density, okay, which is 8.9 grams per centimeter cubed times the volume, okay, which is 23.4 milliliters. Okay, so now, okay, so milliliters and centimeters cubed are the same thing. So I can put these as centimeters cubed. Okay, they are equivalent, so now I can cancel those two out. Okay, so now all I have left is grams. So now I have 8.9 times 23.4. 23.4. Okay, so that tells me it's 208.26. 26 grams, because all I had left here was grams. Okay, so that's number 9. Okay, so for our last one, number 4. Okay, so this is 4. Okay, so blah, 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 blah. Right? Oak wood is generally 0.7 grams per centimeter cubed. Okay, so that's our density. 0.7 grams per centimeter cubed. Okay, if 35 centimeters, if a 35 centimeter cube piece of wood has a mass of 25 grams, what is the wood likely to be? So now we're trying to find out. So this is our reference. Okay, so this is kind of our if. If this is oak, it will equal this. Okay, so we have a, right, so density is equal to mass over volume, because that's what we're looking for. Because we want to see, does this equal 0.7 grams per centimeters cubed. Okay, so what we're going to find is, so the right, so it's 35 centimeters cubed is equal to the volume. Okay, and then the mass is 25 grams. Okay, so what I'm going to have to find is 25 divided by 35. Okay, so I bring my handy calculator. Okay, and so I say 25 divided by 0.714. So that's probably about 0.7, okay, because 0.71 would round to 0.7. So we could say yes, 0.7. Right? So 0.70, because 1 wouldn't necessarily round up. Okay, so you can say yes because it's 0.70. Okay, so that's likely to be oak. Anyway, so hope this helped. So if you have any other questions, you can always text me on Remind. Remember, my Remind account is 81010 at Dressel. Yes, for environmental science. Thanks again.